You might have heard that there's an alien world out there populated only by robots. Mars. It's Mars. Among that population, there are three rovers on its surface working hard right now to help humanity understand what our planetary next-door neighbor is like now, as well as what it used to be like in the past. NASA has sent loads of missions that have gotten loads of attention, from Sojourner in the 1990s to its newest roving expat, Perseverance. But there's one mission you may not have heard of, one that has already spent over a year on the Martian surface. It's China's Zhurong rover, and it's bringing us ever closer to understanding the history of the fourth planet from the sun. Tianwen-1 is China's first independent interplanetary mission, using an orbiter and rover to explore the red planet. The orbiter is also named Tianwen, which means questions to heaven, while the rover is Zhurong, after the Chinese god of fire. They launched together back in July 2020 in the very same launch window as both Perseverance and the United Arab Emirates Hope orbiter. Both orbiter and lander entered the Martian orbit the following February. Then, in May, Zhurong broke away and fell to the surface, landing in the Utopia Planitia Basin. That made China just the third country to complete a soft landing on Mars, after the US and USSR, but the second to have an operational spacecraft, because the Soviets lost communications with theirs soon after landing. Utopia Planitia is the largest impact basin in Mars's northern lowlands, and Zhurong is the first craft to explore the southern part of this region up close. While the exact origins of these lowlands are still being debated, most of it looks like it formed about 3.34 billion years ago. When you've got a rocky body floating out there in space, it's going to get hit by debris over time, so the more craters a patch of crust has, the older it is. Based on the low crater count in Zhurong's location, at least some of Utopia Planitia could be as young as 700 million years old. In other words, the surface may have been wiped clean or renewed somehow. Originally slated for a three-month mission, Zhurong is still going strong as of this writing 1 year later. But over the past year, Zhurong has been busy using its six scientific instruments to peel back the layers of the Martian surface and subsurface. In one case, that's metaphorical, because it has ground-penetrating radar. In another, it's more literal, because it has a laser it uses to vaporize the outer layers of rock samples to figure out what minerals they're made of. The Tianwen orbiter, meanwhile, has the job of relaying all that precious data back to Earth. But it was also used to help confirm exactly where Zhurong was going to land, and is now doing some science of its own. And the results of all this sciencing are slowly rolling out. Like, based on how well the rover's wheels could traverse the surface, scientists were able to show that the surface acts basically like compact sandy soil does on Earth. But overall, it looks like this region of Utopia Planitia has a thin layer of dust and sand sitting on top of a layer of rock known as duracrust, a hardened mix of silicon, aluminum, and iron-based minerals that have cemented together. At least on Earth, this happens after the minerals are deposited by a body of water, which then evaporates. In other words, it's yet another piece of evidence that Mars used to be swimming in liquid water. But one study published in May 2022 using Zhurong's data revealed that liquid water may have been in the area way more recently than scientists thought it was. The research team identified a sample of rocks which looked to have come from the duracrust, and attempted to work out what minerals they were made of. Unfortunately, they weren't able to pin the exact minerals down, but they did figure out that they had water molecules incorporated into their structure. Whether or not this duracrust material is related to other geologic features in the area is currently unknown. We also don't know exactly how the duracrust in this area formed. One possibility is that it was created by groundwater rising up from a lower layer, then evaporating. Another is that the water came from subsurface ice that melted due to a sudden change in temperature caused by volcanism or meteoric impacts. Or the ice could have been melted by a temporary infusion of local liquid water. In that case, the effect would be a lot more limited in size, so an easy way to rule that out would be to send Zhurong further away and see if the same duracrust rocks formed over yonder. Whatever the cause, the presence of this kind of rock in this much younger region of Utopia Planitia suggests that Mars was a bit wetter, at least for longer, than scientists have thought. While Zhurong continues its investigation into Mars's past, scientists on Earth are looking for ways to keep in contact with the little rover while the Tianwen orbiter is busy sciencing. Last year, the European Space Agency tried linking Zhurong up with their orbiter, Mars Express. You might think that'd be as easy as dialing someone else's phone number, but the two communication platforms aren't actually immediately compatible. Out of five tests, only one was successful at sending non-corrupted data. So we'll have to wait to hear if these two space agencies make more progress on that collaboration. Meanwhile, we can celebrate this little guy's achievements, and you can even take Zhurong home with you as this month's Pin of the Month. This year, our pins are celebrating the best in solar system exploration, and this month only, you can pre-order this pin to add to your collection. We'll take pre-orders all this month, after which we'll close orders, make the pin pins and ship them to you. After that, you can never get this one again. But you can get next month's awesome pin, so keep your eyes peeled for that.